Many people take medicine every day, but not many people know how arduous of a process those drugs have to go through to get from an idea to your body. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. The pharmaceutical industry is big business. According to a study published in the annual British Journal of Clinical Pharmacology, world pharmaceutical sales are approximately $365.6 billion. Big Pharma is often portrayed as the villain, sometimes rightfully so. Think of a recent example of a company acquiring a life-saving drug and jacking up the price 4,000% overnight. But it's not always about greed. One of the reasons for the high price of drugs is simply it's so expensive to develop a new one. Developing a new drug or medicine is a slow and expensive road. It can take decades and billions of dollars before a drug ever reaches the FDA, who then has to approve it for use. According to the Association of the British Pharmaceutical Industry, for every successful new drug, about 25,000 chemical compounds were tested. On average, 25 of these will have gone into clinical trials, and just 5 will receive approval for marketing. And according to a report by the Tufts Center for the Study of Drug Development, it costs more than $2.6 billion to make a drug that finally receives approval. So why does it take so much time and money? Well, the FDA, thankfully, has established strict guidelines for drug manufacturers, as well as quality control measures, like good laboratory practices and guidelines for clinical trials. With that in mind, drug discovery often starts with basic research. Scientists might find mechanisms behind cellular receptors, ion channels, and enzymes. For example, research in the 1960s on neurotransmitters led researchers to discover an imbalance of brain chemicals might have something to do with depression. Knowing that, drug companies could get to work on a way to fix that imbalance. Shout out to basic research, woo-hoo! Historically, medicines were discovered in nature, like bark from the willow tree, which ancient cultures used to relieve pain. Turns out, the bark contained a compound, which modern pharmaceutical companies used to make aspirin. Your granddad's pharmaceutical researcher had to create new compounds by hand and could only make about 50 to 100 new compounds every year. But today, using genetics and computer models, researchers can quickly predict what compounds will work and create a bunch of samples using specialized robots. According to a study published in the Pharmaceutical Journal, as many as 10,000 compounds may be considered and whittled down just to 10 to 20. From there, these compounds must be tested. Drugs must go through rigorous testing to make sure they do what researchers suspect and that they don't have overwhelmingly negative side effects. First, compounds must go through either phenotypic screens or target-based screens. Phenotype screening measures the test compound's ability to affect cells, tissues, or whole organisms. It's pretty general. Target screening measures the effect of compounds on a purified target protein in a test tube, so it's way more specific. It's called an in vitro assay, and it targets the direct effect a molecule or compound has down to the protein. Even with the best phenotype screening, the target screening is way more valuable to the scientists and regulators. Only compounds which show positive activity are developed further. They are made in larger quantities and subjected to more and more tests. Some compounds are tested in animals, then they go on to clinical trials, which test the compounds in humans in tightly controlled, highly regulated studies. Phase 1 trials test the safety of the new drugs. Phase 2 tests efficacy. And phase 3 are the holy grail of science, double-blind, placebo-controlled studies. After all of this, if the drug does what it's supposed to do predictably, it can be submitted to the FDA for market approval. So you can imagine, with all this time, effort, money, and a huge failure rate, pharmaceutical companies tend to focus on drugs they think will have the best financial return. Over on Test Tube News, I dig deeper into how exactly drug prices are decided here in the United States. When there is competition, for example, with generic unpatented drugs, companies look at competing medication prices and often charge somewhere in that range. But chemical patents usually expire 20 years after they are filed. Got any other questions about how stuff is made or about the scientific process? Let us know, and remember to use the hashtag AskDNews.